Ice makes some pretty cool sounds. Listen to this frozen bay I recorded up in Lake Ontario.
Or how about the sound of icebergs colliding? And there's this guy, Turja Isingset, who actually makes instruments out of ice.
But maybe my favorite ice sound was captured by YouTuber Cory Williams. This is him, over on his channel, Live Each Day.
At first, the sound just came from Cory throwing rocks. But then the lake started singing on its own.
What is that?
That's a good question.
Good question.
The sound Cory heard is the result of something called acoustic dispersion. A single sound, like ice getting hit by a rock, is made up of vibrations of lots of different frequencies. There's high frequencies, and low frequencies, and everything in between. After the rock hits, those vibrations move outward through the ice, but the higher frequency vibrations go faster than the lower frequency ones. The more ice they travel through, the more spread out they get. The high notes reach your ears first, and then the low ones. Pew!
Sound familiar?
The sound engineers working on Star Wars used the same physics to make that iconic blaster sound. Here's how they did it. They went to an AM radio tower and hit one of these long guide wires with a wrench. As the vibrations run up and down the wire, the frequencies separate, just like they did in the ice. And you can make this sound at home. All you need is a slinky. This is basically just a 70-foot wire all coiled up. Just put a cup in the top to amplify the sound, and let the bottom hit the ground. The sound down here is pretty normal. But by the time those vibrations race around the slinky coils to the top, they've spread out. If you're lucky enough to live near a frozen lake, you don't need a slinky. The lake will make that sound all by itself. The ice expands and contracts, and so it has to buckle and flex, and that sends out vibrations.
Who needs Star Wars, dude? Dude, it's so cool.
Thanks to Cory and Kristen from the Live Each Day channel for their good question. You can catch them vlogging about Alaska almost every day. Send us your science questions and subscribe to Skunk Bear.